Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Ca-BOO-Ret! One and all, my mortal friends. I am your host, your ghost host. After receiving the invitation to come here from my own haunted abode at Disneyland, it is my proud honor to be your host for this ghostly gathering. Tonight, as you know, is a very special kind of night. Not only is the most wicked time of year around the corner, but it is also the first live episode of MiceChat.com's The Haunted Mansion Show, and, most importantly, the inaugural event for Manhattanville's very own, Broadway at Mville. Let us give them a round of applause. Some of you may be thinking, is this skeleton actually talking to me, or is it my imagination? Well, I assure you, my friends, this is no hallucination. It is a true nightmare come to life. Pardon the expression. Is everyone ready for our soiree tonight? Good. Then let us begin our wickedly fun time. A real spooktacular serenade. For our first offering in our Ca-BOO-Ret, we invite some who we call friends of the family to come bring in the inaugural performance for tonight's spooktacular. Please welcome the board members of BAM as they give us a glimpse on what it truly takes to be an Adams. Anytime you're ready, Mr. Andrew Murray!
Ah, the intoxicating smell of the graveyard. Once a year, when the last leaf of autumn falls, we gather to honor the great cycle of life, and yet, come every member of our class, living, dead, and undecided, and let us celebrate what it is to be an Adams.
When you're an Adams, you need to have a little moonlight.
When you're an Adams,
you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way when you're an Adams.
Need to have a sense of humor.
When you're an Adams, you need to have a taste for death.
Ooh, to God.
Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Adams, you need to have a taste for death. When you're an Adams,
you need to grab a bow and arrow.
When you're an Adams,
all right.
Give us shadows, give us love, broken glass in a motel.
Adams family. I do so enjoy family traditions. It reminds me of my childhood. Never knew my parents, really. I like to think it's because my father got the axe in the relationship. Literally. Everyone has one particular fear, if any, around this time of year, and that is ghosts. Whether they come from the deepest reaches of the underworld to haunt the earth, like myself, or in our next song's case, when the ghosts of the past can haunt your lonesome recollection. This leads to a phase of feeling the tragedies, or as they say in France, les misérables. Do give an earful to Christian Bourgeois' lamentation of his café, not just devoid of happiness, but devoid of life. Survived the treacherous battle. Makes me think of that episode of The Twilight Zone where a man is the last survivor from a nuclear war. It also reminds me of another kind of emotion that is surprisingly quite common in terms of its association to melancholy. Love. It can pull us in, the admiring oblivion. How the human eyes can shine ever so brightly, like the glow of a full moon, each with the same central theme of everlasting and ever-haunting admiration. Love. Shh. Listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shannon Gaffney and Deanna Torrisi will sing about what they find in his eyes.
I sit and watch the rain, and see my tears go down my I
as she enlightens us on how she got pulled in.
I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled, and I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction, but I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do?
The night, as Count Dracula once put it. How eloquent he was when he praised about the sweet music they make. Thanks to the forces of affection towards one another, be it romantic or otherwise simply friendly, sweet music is exactly what you get. As I myself like to say, ravens of a feather will caw together. Anger, sorrow, one makes us want to watch the world burn. The other makes us lament about all that we desire. This will be another group of corresponding acts that don't need any further introduction. Well, that and also the fact that I have been informed just now that wretched kids are ruining our grounds with their vandalism, that I must depart temporarily. But I'll see you a little later.
The spirits of Bam's Ca-BOO-Ret call out to Catherine Lyons to sing the song Burn from the hit Broadway musical Hamilton.
I saved every letter you wrote me from the moments I read them.
said. Close to the sun, went for words obsessed with your legacy. Your sentences border on senseless, and you are paranoid in every paragraph. How they perceive you. I'm passing myself from the narrative. Let future historians wonder how lies are reacted. You broke your heart. You have torn it all apart. I'm watching it.
Other commitments, the Pumpkin King Jack Skellington could not be with us tonight. But now, to recall Jack's lament from the Nightmare Before Christmas, please welcome Nicholas Barbera. There are few who deny at what I do I am the best, for my talents are renowned far and wide. When it comes to surprises in the moonlit night, I excel without ever even trying. With the slightest little effort of my ghost-like charms, I have seen grown men give out a shriek. With the wave of my hand and a well-placed moan, I have swept the very bravest off their feet. Yet year after year, it's the same old routine, and I grow so weary of the sound of screams. And I, Jack, the Pumpkin King, have grown so tired of the same old thing. Oh, somewhere deep inside of these bones, an emptiness began to grow. There's something out there far from my home, a longing that I've never known. I'm a master of fright and a demon of light, and I'll scare you right out of your pants. To a guy in Kentucky, I'm Mr. Unlucky, and I'm known throughout England and France. And since I am dead, I can take off my head to recite Shakespearean quotations. No animal nor man can scream like I can with the fury of my recitations. But who here would ever understand that the Pumpkin King with the skeleton grin would tire of his crown if they only understood? He'd give it all up if he only could. Oh, there's an empty place in my bones that calls out for something.
time has come. It is the bewitching hour, and our first part of our Ca-BOO-Ret must come to a close. But don't worry, my friends. The spirits of the underworld shall recollect the memories we shared of this spooktacular night for our second part. Rather than provide you with an anticlimax, I wish to provide you with Shakespeare from the epic poem Venus and Adonis. Hard-favored tyrant, ugly, meager, lean, hateful divorce of love, thus chides she death. Grim, grinning ghost, earth's worm, what dost thou mean to stifle beauty and to steal his breath? Who, when he lived, his breath and beauty set gloss on the rose, smell to the violet. And I do have one more thing, but I need you to come closer, closer, closer. Boom!
Boom to you,